after catastrophic flooding devastated communities across Queensland and New South Wales. Residents have criticised the government, saying they felt abandoned, with calls for help unanswered. The Australian Defence Force was deployed to help and have been on the ground carrying out rescues and also aiding in the mammoth clean-up efforts that are currently underway. Brigadier Robert Lording is in Lismore and joins us now. Brigadier Lording, thanks so much for your time. What is the situation on the ground there at the moment?
So I've currently got 1,800 people on the ground here. We expect them to grow to 2,500 before the end of the day, with a plan to get up to 4,000 people here in the Northern Rivers by the end of the week.
4,000...
We've got crews out this morning, engineers.
Wow, yep. 4,000 soldiers on the ground by the end of the week in Lismore.
Yeah, that's 4,000 members of the Australian Defence Force. So it's across Army, Navy and Air Force. Mm-hmm.
Flood victims have criticised the time taken for the rollout of boots on the ground. Has the government response been too slow?
Look, I would say from my perspective, you know, the ADF was actually here on the ground. I actually had members of one of my battalions here before the weather event actually occurred, and they were providing support right from the get-go. I think what's important to understand is that, you know, we had to project the forces in here from outside, and the floodwaters had not receded until, you know, Friday. At the earliest was the opportunity we could get the large number of people on the ground, getting over those flooded roads and into the locations where we can help. One of the other key points is that we need to be able to sustain those people when they come forward. You know, we need to have the places to accommodate them, to have the rations, the food, the fuel that they need to be able to do the job. If we don't have that in place, we start to take that away from the local communities, and they desperately need that.
Yeah, that definitely makes sense. Can you give us an idea of how big the scale of the damage is in Lismore? What we've seen on television, it looks obviously heartbreaking, but what are you actually up against there?
Look, I think the one that you're seeing the most is, particularly in the CBD and some of the residential areas, the amount of damage that's occurred, the sheer volume of material that's been moved from premises out onto the streets for it to be collected. That creates a significant hazard, both to the community and to the people who are working on it. You know, it potentially contains asbestos. There are lots of biological agents. We've got dead animals. So that's one of our key focuses, is to get that refuse off the street so that we can actually set the conditions for the council engineers and for the other people to come forward and to then get into people's houses so they can get on with the longer-term recovery efforts.
You've said that 4,000 ADF personnel will be on the ground in the Northern Rivers by the end of the week, but we've still got that heavy rain threatening communities along the east coast, including parts of Sydney. Will any of those troops in the Northern Rivers be diverted away to Sydney?
No. At this stage, we've put on the 6th Aviation Regiment down in Holsworthy, have been readied in case we need to provide them with aviation support in the Sydney Basin, or indeed through the Hunter Valley and out up to the mid-north coast. I've currently got 250 people as a contingency force based in Sydney ready to go.
Residents are being told that the ADF are still currently in rescue mode, meaning that bigger clean-up jobs that the ADF are needed for are being put on hold. Is that the case?
Look, I would say that what we saw was that the search, rescue and evacuation operations really kept us occupied probably through Friday and Saturday, but particularly around that time we then started to move towards the support. That meant we started doing airdrops of food. We started to send crews in with vehicles. So we're not really in that rescue operations mode now. We're certainly making long strides to get into recovery, and we're doing that with the SES and with the other New South Wales agencies.
Yeah, the scale of the disaster is absolutely enormous, but certainly the locals will be very glad to see ADF personnel there on the ground. Brigadier Robert Lording, thank you so much for your time today. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.